We haven't stood up a while.
I know.
On this show, hey.
I'm just happy to see the man that's standing next to you.
Okay, let's introduce him. Hello. Welcome back to Sister Circle Live. Of course, June is Men's Health Month to raise awareness of preventable health problems and encourage early detection of disease.
Yes, and most importantly, to support our men in going to the doctor.
Yes.
And here to break down some of the health issues that black men are facing is the one and only resident doctor of Sister Circle.
Yes,
Dr. Dave.
Hey.
Hey, Dr. Dave.
What's happening?
Oh, you're looking so Dapper Dave.
Thank you, man.
Or Dapper Dave.
That's right. Dapper Dave. I like it. That's the new one.
That was so lame.
I like that.
We're so happy to have you back.
Happy
here.
To be back.
All right, so let's talk a little bit about this. Early detection is key. We all know that. But what do we do to encourage our men to actually get up and go to the doctor?
Yeah, that's a big deal, right?
Yes.
So we've talked about this, and we talked about it before. Mm-hmm. Men don't go to the doctors like women go to. Think about this, though. This is one of the only times where men are expected, when you walk through the door, to outsource your masculinity.
Mm.
You gotta give it up, right?
Okay,
what's masculine? The self-reliance, like I can do it on my own, right? I'm strong, I'm invincible, some of us think that, right?
Mm-hmm.
You know, everything's perfectly fine. You're gonna go to somebody and say, actually, no, it's not perfectly fine, and that is a challenge. So here's what we need y'all to do,
okay?
If we're gonna have a conversation about it so you can understand what all my misgivings are from way back when the pediatrician did that or that or the other, you gotta have a conversation without disparaging remarks, without condescension, without I told you so.
Yeah.
It's not the one-up game. Because if you're gonna make it a wedge issue, you just might as well forget about it.
Yeah.
Right?
Give me an example.
I have had...
So I'm the man, and you beat me, and you tell me.
Well, that's hard because you're beautiful. But so here's what I'll say.
Okay.
I see multiple couples come into my office, and if I'm not careful, it'll feel like we're double teaming the guy because he's like, see, I told you, but you know, and if you're doing that, you just forget about it. First of all, he's not going to share with you. We're going to have a problem. I have to then say to myself, let me get on his side very quickly so that that won't be an issue. So so we need y'all to work some of that magic, right? Some of that magic that y'all work when you get us to do something that we thought of, but y'all thought of it first. That's that magic. And then every once in a while, go ahead and schedule that appointment for us. Because you know the guys sometimes that we kind of raggedy with that.
Sometimes. So let's talk about some health issues that our black men are
facing. Quantum right here.
Yeah.
I was going to ask about
it.
Now. Everybody. So tell us about some of the risks that black men are faced with.
Yeah, so there's a lot of them, right? So we have the biggest ones, as you know, all relate to the heart. Mm-hmm. It's heart attack and stroke. It's hypertension, especially for African Americans.
Yeah.
That leads to all kinds of badness. Kidney dialysis, heart failure, all of those things. Let's jump to prostate cancer and lung cancer. Those are very important cancers. Still number one cancer is lung cancer. Mm-hmm. Number one person that dies from prostate cancer is African American men, and there are a whole list of these other ones as well.
All right. So we're supposed to be playing a game.
Yeah, we're gonna play a game.
Okay.
Now I got these paddles that I made at home.
You made them? No, they made it for me. You got glitter paddles.
We got true or false. We're gonna do a true or false game. Once you hand quad one of those.
Okay, gotcha, baby.
And you know how we do this. I want you to answer true or false to these. These are tricky now, so pay attention. First one, true or false. If you work out, you can't have a heart attack or stroke. Now, we all know that that's
very false.
But there are some guys right now in the gym having other symptoms, things like that, because I work out.
No, that's false.
Go see somebody, because not everything that can harm you hurts you.
That is true.
You need to let me check you out.
Yeah, okay? You never know what's going on inside of your body.
Yeah, that's why you got to go get somebody who knows how to do that.
Absolutely.
That's your boy. Shameless plug. Okay, all right. Number two, let's do a second one here. True or false? If this is a bit, pay attention now.
Okay.
If my man is having problems in the bedroom, I'm doing something wrong.
Who, meaning a woman?
Yeah, that's false.
Exactly. And the reason why I knew you were going to get it, like, I don't ever do nothing
wrong. Right, right.
That's another show. But so here's the point about that. When men are having erectile dysfunction, what we know in cardiology is that is heart disease, heart and vascular disease, until proven otherwise, right?
Wow.
We got about 25% of 35, 40-year-old men having repeated issues with erectile function. That is a vascular problem. It's a blood vessel until proven otherwise. You need to come see your boy on that one. Let's get to the bottom of it.
Oh,
all right? Very important.
I never knew that.
Yeah.
And they're so shameful of that at times.
Well, that's why you come and see your boy by yourself. Don't bring your girl with you. Let's talk about
that.
It's really important. Okay?
Right.
Number three is a true or false as well. If you start taking pills, you become dependent on them.
you can become or you do you, become?
Whichever one you want.
Okay, if you can,
I just need
I'm
going
to say can, and I'm going to say that's true.
That's true. Okay, so that is one of the myths. It is false. That's one of the myths, and I see that, I hear that all the time, okay? Not just African-Americans, Caucasians, Asians, everybody has this mythology that if I start taking a pill, I'm somehow dependent on, like it's a narcotic or something.
Mm. Okay.
And what we really need to do is change our focus on that and say, as long as I need to reduce my risk for something or treat something that I can't otherwise treat naturally, I need to take the medicine,
okay.
Right?
Okay.
That's what
and
the
issue
is. And
there are ways, with changing your diet, exercise, that you can wean yourself off of those medications.
There are,
right.
Unless you got a gene.
How?
Right?
Yeah.
And how do you know that?
Yeah.
Well, you got to come see
the doctor. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, one last one.
Here's this is a really important one. If prostate cancer does not run in my family, I don't have to worry about it. All right, now here's a, this is real, this is a big one for guys because the real way to tell that you have prostate cancer is not a blood test. The real way to tell if you have prostate cancer is a digital rectal exam. And it's not fun for guys, but you have to have it done.
Yeah.
And unless you do it, depending on your risk factor, you should be doing 45 or 50. African-American men probably on the younger end of that, then you don't know if you have it or not.
Oh my goodness.
Because the blood test is not accurate.
Right,
oh
wow.
Yeah. Dr. Dave, do you have any other words of advice or tips or anything that you can give our men out there?
Yeah, you know, I think what I take the stance of is when you walk through my door is you've hired me to do a job, right? Mm-hmm. I work for you. So I tell all my guys, go hire a doctor that you trust. And number two, if you don't believe what he said, go get a second or third opinion. But you got to do what they say if all three of them say
something. Yeah, yeah,
right?
That is true.
God
that
is trying to tell you something.
Yes, I'm right.
Right now.
Dr. Dave, thank you so much. That's your boy. For more information, make sure you go follow Dr. Dave. His website is an amazing website. You can learn more about his preventative care practice at preventatl.com. There we go. Give it up for Dr. Dave.
Yeah.
Yes.